Hi everyone, I'm on a class 390 Pendolino and I will use this fantastic train to explain the working of tilting trains. Let's start at the beginning. I started my journey from Glasgow Central. Opened on 1st August 1879, Glasgow Central is a historic station with a beautiful architecture. There's a lot of history associated to the station. This plaque commemorates the men and women who boarded trains here to join the battle to defend and protect freedom from the dark forces of Hitler. I'm taking the morning 9:40 Avanti 390 Pendolino to London Euston. My train is a 9-car unit. We will travel on the West Coast Main Line and cover the 399 miles to London Euston in 4.5 hours at an average speed of 90 miles per hour. Maximum speed will be 125 miles per hour. The Class 390 has a designed top speed of 140 miles per hour but is restricted to a maximum service speed of 125 miles per hour due to limitations of track signaling systems. Unlike the East Coast Main Line, which has long stretches of flat straight track, the West Coast Main Line is laid on a hilly terrain with numerous curves along the track. Trains like the HST-125 became very successful on the East Coast Main Line because they could be run at 125 miles per hour. Running trains at high speeds on the West Coast Main Line was, however, challenging. This led to the development of the tilting advanced passenger train, now preserved at the Rail Heritage Centre in Crewe. Unlike an airplane, which can bank into a curve, a train is unable to bank into a curve. Banking into a curve reduces the effects of centrifugal forces that can throw you and your belongings all over. Railway tracks are intentionally canted at curves, with the outer rail being at a higher level than the inner to counter centrifugal forces. In the UK, this cant can be up to 6 degrees. Given the curve radii typically encountered on the West Coast Main Line, this meant that even with the maximum permissible amount of cant applied, speeds couldn't be increased much above the 100 miles per hour range without, once again, experiencing excessive lateral forces. Fortunately, the factor limiting speeds is not safety against derailing or overturning, but rather only passenger comfort. The solution to increasing speeds further is therefore having the train car bodies tilt as well. While this doesn't influence the forces acting at the wheel rail level, it keeps the lateral forces experienced inside the passenger compartment at a comfortable level even at further increased speeds. Therefore, rather than spending large money on relaying tracks, British Rail decided to counter the centrifugal forces by making the train tilt. It was calculated that a tilt of 8 degrees could be sufficient to provide a comfortable journey while not making the passengers nauseous. When combined with the tilt system, the train was theorized to comfortably take curves at a 20% greater speed than it otherwise would be able to do so. Faults in the prototypes and the resultant bad press killed the APT project, and British Rail sold the technology to Fiat Ferroviaria, which is now a part of Alstom. To make a long story short, Virgin Trains brought the tilting trains back to the UK in the guise of the Class 390. The Class 390, now operated by Avanti West Coast, is a definite, refined improvement on the failed APT. Before describing how the tilting mechanism works, I would like you to witness the active tilting in action. My train is running on the curving tracks of the Lake District in England. As the train negotiates a curve, notice the tilt occurring in real time. The angle of tilt from the horizontal can be up to 8 degrees on the Class 390 Pendolino. As the train completes the curve, it returns to level. A gyroscope fitted in the car body detects deviations from the horizontal when the train approaches the banked curve. At the same time, a sensor measures the centrifugal forces acting on the car body as it negotiates the curve. The gyroscope and the sensor send this data to an onboard computer that calculates and activates the electrically operated tilt actuators which are situated under each carriage. To overcome the lag between the sensors detecting the curve and the activation of the tilt, the Class 390 Pendolino uses a tilt authorization and speed supervision system, or TAS for short. TAS relies upon trackside transponder balizers typically placed about 5 miles apart, which transmit data to the train. While the Class 390 has made 125 mile per hour travel possible on the twisting electrified route of the West Coast main line, the diesel-electric Class 221 Super Voyager trains with hydraulic actuated tilt system were acquired to run at high speed around bends on unelectrified sections of cross-country West Coast mainline and the North Wales coastline. The tilt system has been disabled on the cross-country units as these routes are not cleared for tilting operation. Compared to the Class 800 or other non-tilting rolling stock, the Class 390 and 221 car bodies are narrower. This is to allow for the extra clearances required when active tilt is in operation. The narrow car bodies of the Class 390 and Class 221 can make the passengers feel claustrophobic. Nevertheless, the Class 390 has offered fast journey times on the West Coast main line. The Glasgow-Euston run is completed in 4.5 hours. Seating in the standard class is airline type, with 2 seats on each side and a narrow aisle in between. The first class is more spacious but also significantly higher in cost. Avanti Class 390s have a shop that serves drinks and refreshments on board.
The air is so hot, like, no, it's okay.
It's okay.
Hi, everyone.
What are your views? If you like this video and other videos on my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon.